7 in the software testing, and I was working for Sun Life Financial. It's a more finance group company, and we were doing mainly with the life insurance and health insurance and every other mortgage insurance, all the stuff. But I was mainly focusing on testing applications on life insurance products. I worked there for 4 years and then I moved to TD Bank. TD Bank is one of the leading financial group in Canada. And then I was mainly working on testing the application for the new credit cards. Like every point of time we get a lot of new credit cards, so we have to test them up and every browser and all that stuff. So I worked there for 1.5 year. And I'm pretty much well versed with the both manual testing and automation testing. And the reason why I applied for this job is, like, I've been actively trading since 3 years and I have more keen interest towards trading and economics and derivatives and all commodity stuff. So I thought this would be the right position for me. So that's why I applied for this. No, it's my personal trading. I do trade for myself, and I have one of my friends, like she has companies in Saskatoon, and I trade for her too. So it's kind of personal trading, it's not like institution trading. Yeah, I trade mostly with the stock market and some I do trade some commodities like gold, shorting and then buying. But mostly I do short trading and then long term and short term. I don't do day trading. So that's how I deal with it, and most of, yeah, I've been trading since 3 years and it's going pretty well so far. Yeah, derivative is a financial product which derives the value of a underlying value of a company's asset, and bonds in a similar way, which raises the company raises the money from the customers for its operations or whatever it needs it for. And commodities, they're like oil, gold, like any oil commodities in the market, like food products like maize and other stuff, and metals, copper, silver. These are the main commodities. And yeah, they fluctuate the market according to the market demand and supply. So as far as now, the gold is under pressure because of the global economic crisis. Because last time it happened with Italy, they have almost under debt crisis, so they're about to sell their gold reserves. So market is feeling under pressure now, so that's why gold price have been falling since last couple of months. So it was reached 1200 last month, a month ago, then that was the stability point, because the production cost for the gold is almost across all other regions in the world, like 900 in Europe and 1100 in Africa, somewhere like it reached up to 1080 or 1100. So it's pretty sure that the gold price won't go below 1100. So I thought that would be the bottommost point. Maybe it may reach 1150, 1180, that's it. But the gold price reached just to 100 and then it rocketed above. It's trading around 1330 today. So yeah, I do trade a lot of analysis on how things going on across the world and stuff. That's a major interest, yeah. Different types of derivatives. Mostly I deal with like stock market. I'm sorry? Over conference trading? No, I'm sorry, No. But I have keen interest, or I can learn, like, if I get an opportunity, I can learn about all those financial products and more in depth. Yeah, so it's just mainly my interest, so. And there's a certification in Canada that exists called CSC, Canadian Security Certificate. I'm working on it. Hopefully I'll be done with maybe in 2-3 months. It got 2 papers to go through, so. Yeah, the derivatives, some derivatives that I deal with, like contracts, option contracts, I do only options and derivative stuff. Options is obligation to find a product, to buy a product, and it's kind of security, call option, put option. So, for example, the price, for example, I want to buy a house, the price of a house is trading at $200,000 now, but I want to buy after 6 months. So I want to make sure that even the prices goes up, I want to make sure that I can get the price of the house for $200,000. So that's an option. It's giving an option for you to buy a product for a specific time period. Yeah. So it's very risk oriented, but it's still got its own advantages when you clearly have an idea about the market, how exactly it's going. For example, if you think real estate is going up now, so it's a good idea to buy an option on them. But you have to have clear analysis. If you don't, then it would be in the risk analysis. You have to assess a lot of risk and stuff. Maybe it will be a good option when you diversify your portfolio. Some in options, some in derivatives, and some in stocks, some in foreign exchange, bonds, something like that. Yeah, the company has almost all life products, like life insurance, health insurance, and real estate security insurance. But I was working for the life insurance domain. In life insurance, we have term life insurance, permanent life insurance, universal. In the term, we have multiple, like 10 years term and 20 years term life insurance. Insurance is like insuring a product, insuring a person, or insuring a health, like giving you the risk, giving you something in exchange of payment. Like, for example, if health is insured, like if something goes wrong, then you're insured by something like money, in terms of money or something else. So it's like trading, like you're insuring with equitable transfer. I mean, say I don't know how to say it, but yeah, that's how it is, insurance. Like, yeah, yes, I did work in Agile. Agile model is more popular in these days. Agile model has both the Scrum and Sprint model. The project is subdivided into each sprint. Each module subdivided into each sprint. Each sprint have definite time period, like 1 week to 6 weeks, depends on the company. And then we have a specific task to be half completed in the specific, in that particular sprint time. So at the end of the sprint end deadline, we have to make sure that all functionality have to be tested, and we have to make that sprint all like flowchart, like represented how many bugs have been identified and what's the process, what is the status and stuff. And once the sprint goals have been fixed, that's entered into the product master or product master, all I mean to say, once the goals have been decided by the test manager, like that sprint is given to the development team so that we won't make any more modifications on the particular sprint. So we only get the sprint only at the end of the sprint is done. So it helps us to focus on what exactly the goals have been decided. Because if team leader or whoever, quality manager have a command over what is the sprint goal, so if something is not met because of any other reason, so they may change it. So in order to make sure nothing's gonna happen, like not to make sure the product have to flow according to the planned strategy, so it goes to the control of the development team and then we assess it after each sprint is done. And each day we have a meeting with all team members and team lead. We discuss what exactly, how's things going, any difficulties and all this stuff. And end of the sprint time, and at the end of the sprint time, we have like all that particular sprint performance, how many bugs found, what is the flow chart, how many have to be executed, how many, you know, retesting cases, how many, and all this stuff. Yes, sure. A test strategy is a particular part or component in test software development lifecycle. It mainly discusses the strategy, how to approach a strategy to process the software testing. But test plan is a document that collects and organizes test cases by functional areas and types of testing and form that can be presented to the other teams. I mean to say both are pretty much close but not same. Test strategy is the strategy how to approach the testing, but the test plan can be done any test engineer or QA engineer, but test strategy have to be done with a QA lead or QA manager. They should have all the knowledge about what are the tasks and responsibilities, what is the method of testing have to be used, and the split of what are the roles. Like for example, I have three QA team members, so they divide the work allocation, the manpower allocation, how many tests have to be discussed, and if any change request comes, like risk and if any manpower loses, so they do have information on the mitigation, how to overcome those risks. So test strategy have like full strategy in the process of performing or completing the process of testing. Yeah, traceability matrix is mainly, the main purpose of the traceability matrix is to not to miss any of the functionalities in the development of a software product. So it can be done by the mapping of the from the stage one, each phase of the software development lifecycle. For example, like requirement document to design and the coding and then testing. So from in the testing process, test scenarios and the test cases, each test case whether it's performed or not. So it's kind of mapping each stage of the development process to make sure that all the functionalities in the end product have been covered or have been met. That's the main functionality of the traceability matrix. I'm sorry? Automation scripting. Automated scripting, we have a descriptive testing and non-descriptive. Descriptive is descriptive testing. We define the value for the variables, and so it takes more time. But generally, depending on the situation, and for the descriptive programming, it takes a lot of time. But There was a situation in my last prof. Regular expressions are used to, for example, there is a situation where for I want to display a name of something. It starts with A, and then I use regular expression. So I don't care what exactly happens after first letter K. So it starts with K and then ends with a particular number of characters or numbers. So this is more helpful, like in the process of what is called database and finding the modifying the database elements or retrieving the database elements like names and modifying them. For example, in the backend testing, I want to find some Mr. Travis records. So I don't know the last name or something. So I use T and then I use regular expression so that I can make sure that all the records which start with the letter T that comes into my record so that I can pick from them. Okay. 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 But do I have the requirement document or not? So yeah, I mean if the BA and the developer is not busy, I would take their help to discuss the application or to understand the application. And if I have no possibility that I won't get the time, then I would do like a random testing. Or I would try to assess the application if at all I understand the application. So obviously as a tester I have the basic knowledge about the domain, right? So I have, based on my knowledge, I will assess the main major functionalities or critical functionalities. For example, if it is a Gmail application, the mainly people use for inbox, compose mail and send items. So I would focus on main, like high priority applications. And then if I don't, obviously I have knowledge, for example in a situation, if I don't have a knowledge, then I will do random testing. Whatever I have done is right, and that's the typical question. If I have the knowledge of the domain, then I would be able to assess what is right and what is wrong. But as a QA analyst, I would be having a basic knowledge of the domain, even though my QA and BA is busy and I don't have requirement specification documents. So I will try to assess myself, and if not, I will go with the same application with some other company having same features. So I'll compare the features, then I'll try to assess myself. Okay. I had a question, like how many rounds is interview, or just one round, or what is the process of hiring? Okay. You said five. Okay. Yeah, all right, that sounds great. And they have sent me an email. Yeah, I know. Yeah, I understand what you mean. Yeah, okay. That sounds good. Not yeah. Thank you for calling, and that's all I have now. Yeah. Yeah, that sounds great. Thank you very much for calling. Yeah, I'll see you.